if you ask songwriters from my generation, my and Donald's generation, about who's, who were the important lyricists from their time, Bob Dylan is always going to be mentioned. And if only, and I don't think that what we do sounds much like Bob Dylan, but he was the guy that sort of opened the door to a larger world of possibilities and realized that by superimposing more interesting or more literate or more obscure or more extravagant lyrics on rock and roll beats, you would end up with something intriguing.
We were sort of the first TV generation. I was interested in TV music, movie soundtracks. I could sometimes tell who wrote the score just from hearing the music, if it was Elmer Bernstein or Dave Grusin or Alex North or whoever. And also I there was like sort of cheap music, like TV music or movie music. By cheap, I simply mean, not really in a disparaging way, but it's written to support something else. It's not pure music, but it's rather written to support visual information. There was something also funny about that music. There was something funny about the theme from The Twilight Zone, something funny about the jazz score for The Sweet Smell of Success, because it was like fake jazz, essentially. And so I both like real jazz and also fake jazz and also fake jazz.